Hello guys, and welcome back for a brand new review. As I promised a few days ago, today we're gonna have a look at the differences between the UltraBoost 21 and UltraBoost 22. If you are new to the channel, please make sure you're gonna subscribe. You can also leave some comments in the comment section down below, and of course don't forget to press the like button if you've enjoyed this content. In today's video guys, we're gonna have a look at the UltraBoost 21 and we're gonna compare it of course with the UltraBoost 22, which was released just a few days ago here in UK for a retail price of 165, which will be £5 more than the UltraBoost 21, which is still available on the Adidas website in a lot of color combinations. Unfortunately, the UltraBoost 22 has just 3 for the moment, but they will change this in the next few months. So guys, it's pretty clear that the 21 and the 22 share the same platform and they have the same size. They have just tweaked a few things around, like the actual materials and the breathability. They've changed also slightly the cage, even though they appear to just be small modifications to the actual shoe. I will need to admit that the 22 has some big improvements. So let's go ahead and do a side-by-side comparison guys. As you can see, the actual upper will be the same prime knit which we had it on the 21, but as you can see guys, the actual pattern changed slightly, so we're not gonna have the same perforation holes on the side as well. It's gonna be just here on the toe box section area, and we're gonna have some more just underneath these laces. While the old one of course didn't have as much, but it had something here just underneath this cage. So that's gonna be the biggest difference for the actual prime knit. Then as we go to the actual cages guys, you can see that we're gonna have a small differences for the new one. So we are not gonna have four eyelets here in this cage. The last one will be actually be a loophole, which I've said in the actual review for this one that I find it to be a bit strange, but of course they had to change something though, so I guess this one is just a design one. And also for this one, as you can see, the last eyelet will be slightly a bit bigger and will have a small border. I guess this one will try to keep your laces tighten a bit better. Also here at the top of this tongue section, I would say they've actually changed slightly this tag, so this one feels a bit more raised and has I would say a padding, if I can say so, while the old one just was a very thin rubberized one. As you go to the actual heel support counter guys, you can see that we're gonna have the same one. It has the same shape and it will have this UltraBoost written on the lateral side. Also as you go inside, the actual padding and also the lining feels completely the same, so nothing changed there. Also the insole, the foam one, is gonna be completely the same. But as you can see now inside, for the new one we have a slightly different material for the footbed, which for the UltraBoost 21, as you might know, we had that very nice felt material, if I can say so, which if you had to take the insole out, you could have just used the shoe without it. While for this new UltraBoost 22, I really feel that when I'm taking the insole out, that material on the footbed feels slightly more abrasive, and it's annoying me after just few minutes of wearing. So in case you were wondering if you can use this one without that insole, most definitely you can try, but after a few minutes that will start to feel a bit strange underfoot. Now going to this Boost midsole guys, you can see that this one is completely unchanged. It has the same height, it has the same shape. and depending of the color which you're gonna take the shoe, you're gonna have or not a side stripe here at the lateral side. But the main change for the Ultra Boost 22 is that I really feel that this one changed and it's actually a bit more squishy. So most definitely this one will give you more comfort and a better responsiveness. So I guess if you had a problem with the Ultra Boost 21, that you find it that it was actually a bit too hard, most definitely the Ultra Boost 22 has that problem solved. And of course guys, now we're gonna go to this rubber outsole, which as you can see it has totally the same pattern and the same shape. But the most important thing that I find for the Ultra Boost 22 is that this LEP system located here at the front of the shoe, it actually become a bit more softer than the Ultra Boost 21. So as you can see, this one now it's much easier to fold it. So that means it will let your foot to flex a bit more, which a lot of people found that for the Ultra Boost 21 that was an issue. As you can see, this one it's actually quite hard to fold. So in case you really had a problem with the old one, this new one got that problem fixed. So overall guys, the new Ultra Boost 22, as you can see, it looks almost the same with the old Ultra Boost 21. But I guess everyone was expecting that. As you might know, the Ultra Boost 19 was very similar with the Ultra Boost 20. So I think it was something which everyone was expecting, that the 21 to be very similar with 22, which in this case I would say that I wasn't expecting. I mean, we have very little differences for the actual design, but given that they've changed the actual pattern for this new Prime Knit, I really feel that this one is slightly a bit more stretchier than the old one. So most definitely I felt that this one feels more comfortable on foot. Yes, the most important thing will be that this Boost midsole became slightly more comfortable than this one, which it was already comfortable as it was. And given that they decided to make this LEP system a bit more softer, I really felt that this one it gives a better comfort and a better give overall. So the Ultra Boost 22, it's not a very big improvement, but a very good one, I would say. So yeah guys, this was my comparison of the Ultra Boost 21 with the Ultra Boost 22. I really hope these details will help you in deciding which one you should go for. And I really hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to press the like button, maybe also subscribe to the channel. You can also leave some comments in the comment section down below. And as always, I will see you in my next one. Thanks for watching!